Hi, I'm Spike from Skarnsundet Fjord Centre in Norway, and today I wanted to do a really short film about what I wear when I go shore fishing. Basically anywhere from autumn to spring. This is the type of kit that I wear. It's called layering. Start off with a good woolen pair of socks. You only want to really wear one pair of socks, kind of knee high, and good quality wool. Keeps your feet nice and warm. A bit tight, this one. Second thing is thermals. Merino wool thermal trousers. Fantastic. Keep you really warm. And they're quite tight, quite lightweight as well. That's one half done. Same type of stuff, but just with the top. Slip that. There we go. Halfway there. Yeah, so good base layer really. Moving on next is my trousers. Waterproof, windproof trousers. These are from North Face Summit series. I don't really know what that means. But they're waterproof, insulated, and quite lightweight. Got a few different pockets on them and that. I usually buy my stuff secondhand. These were secondhand. I think they're made for skiing. But they were 50 quid secondhand. Had them a few weeks now. No problems with them, being out in some rain and some snow. You know, kept me dry and warm. Quite adjustable there. You can fit a belt on them as well if you want to do. I'm not sponsored by North Face. I don't really care what I wear. It's just as long as it does the job. You know, sometimes you're better off buying these things secondhand than new, because they are quite expensive new, but if the skiers have used them, they tend to get rid of them quite quickly, and you can pick up some real bargains secondhand. Good hard wearing fleece. I don't know what makes are the best really. This is Norheim, a Norwegian make. I've had it for years. Yeah, you can see it's kind of not woolen, but it's got some type of thermal layer on it, one piece. Great. So that goes on next. Usually, that's warm enough, to be honest. That would usually keep me warm enough for a 6-hour session. I like spring, autumn, winter if it's nice and mild. If it gets really cold, I have a Helly Hansen down jacket. Really warm. I'll have that on if I get really cold. But the only thing I don't like about it is that they restrict you a little bit when you're trying to move. So although they're really warm, I won't wear it unless it's absolutely necessary. Also carry a rain jacket with me. Quite lightweight. There's no thermal protection in these jackets. This is just purely for when it really starts to rain or snow, just to keep the water off. So branding wise, it doesn't really matter. There's some expensive and there's some cheap, really good brands out there. Again, this was secondhand. It's a Gore-Tex jacket. This was a secondhand jacket by Sims. I think I paid 100 quid for it, which is good for this type of jacket. I mean, these are 400 quid new. But again, picked it up off eBay, I think, secondhand. And it'll do me for probably 5 or 6 years, this jacket. You don't wear them that often. But then you really need to have one with you when you come into Norway. Good hat. Good woolen bobbly hat. You've got to have it. You've got to have it when you come to Norway. Nice, makes it nice and easy wearing your headlamp as well. Keeps your head nice and warm, doesn't itch. It's just a cheap one as this, but it's got like a thermal lining on it here. That's great. Pair of gloves. Get asked all the time, what's the best gloves that you wear? These are one of these quid a pair. tight. I've got rubber on the outside and like covering on the other side. Come up just past the wrist. They're perfect. I never take these off when I'm fishing. You can bait up with them, cast with them, reel in, land fish. Keep your hands relatively warm. I mean, they're not as good as the insulated gloves, but the problem is with the insulated gloves, they're too big, they're too thick, they're too clumsy. You're always taking them off and on. I leave these on. Usually I'll take a couple of pairs with me, because when the first one gets really bad or wet, just change it and put the other ones on. I mean, they're that cheap, you can throw them away after a couple of sessions. Most important bit of kit I have, my boots. These are Snowline Super Sport 12.5. I'm not sure what that means. They come from a company called Rock Grip. A guy called Paul Rogers. He studs them up. They're fantastic. The best boots I've ever worn. I've had these ones now for 5 years. And I wear them twice a week in pretty harsh, rough conditions. They've got all their studs in still. on both sides, they've got all their studs in. All right, they've worn down a little bit, but none of them are out. I've tried kicking them out, they don't come out. They're fantastic. They've got loads of stability here, which is what you need. I mean, when you're fishing in Norway, sometimes you're fishing on a wooden pier, nice and easy. There's still going to be ice there. Especially fishing during the winter, slippery rocks, and even not in the winter, a lot of these rocks are covered with weed or this green algae stuff. You're always slipping everywhere. I don't know how I managed to fish without them. I think I'd been in Norway a year before I started wearing them. People get concerned about if they're down to minus 40 or minus 60. I don't know how cold, apparently you can go down in these, but it doesn't really matter. Because when it gets to minus 20, you won't be fishing anyhow. It's just too cold. I've fished in minus 20, minus 25 before. It gets, the feet are your least of your worries when it gets so cold. But yeah, look at the other one. Vibram soles. I mean, I'm not saying you have to go out and buy a pair of these boots just to come to Norway. I would suggest you do, to be honest, because you can wear them at home, and I know how important these boots are to me. I couldn't fish as effectively as I do if I didn't have these. Your other solution is you wear your normal boots and you bring crampons. They're all right, but crampons tend to come off a lot and they move a lot. You don't have that confidence in your footing. And all anglers know, if you don't really have that, you won't make a nice cast. You'll always be frightened about going in and landing your fish. You won't get to the water, sometimes where you need to be to land fish, to get over the ledges. So it's their money well spent. I'm not sponsored by Rock Grip, or I just know Paul, but it's certainly a piece of equipment I would recommend. All right, I hope it's been a bit helpful. Let us know in the comments if there's anything else you want to see, and I look forward to seeing you soon.